This is my three-legged sawhorse. For most situations, it would be sturdy enough, and I've made them so they'll fold up. If you were to do any sawing, then you'd do this end where it's more stable. But if you were just placing things on top, then that's stable enough just for that. If you need something very substantial, then this probably isn't the thing to use. A three-legged sawhorse is going to be more stable on uneven ground. The main thing I wanted was a foldable sawhorse. The last ones I had, they were getting in my way. I ended up leaving them outside and they just rotted. We need to get three legs out of this one piece. To do that, I've measured 800. If you've not used a speed square before to mark an angle, then we pivot it on our mark there, this point, until we find the angle that we want. And here we want 5 degrees. Then make our mark. Then using the leg that we just cut, we can transfer the mark off that one to make our second leg. On the single leg, it needs a 10 degree angle. So using our speed square, use the corner as the pivot point and find 10. And now we need two 930mm pieces for the top. Two of these leg supports, and they're on a 5 degree angle to stop the leg going back any further. So we need two of those, and then just the spacer there that can be cut off square. Using that piece, we can measure the other one. Then we need the square one, which I think was 65. Yes, 65. Next, we need to make a pair of wedges for either leg. And they're there so the legs are splayed out and also they can be stored away flat against the top of the sawhorse. The wedge needs to be cut at an angle of 4:1 depending on the thickness and material you use. So in this case it's 35 across, so that makes 140. This is quite a tricky cut, but take your time and you should manage. And try and keep it straight. I'm going off a little bit there. Let's readjust. That looks good. This doesn't need to be accurate because they get cut down again later. And the last part we need to cut is this leg stop here, which is cut at 10 degrees. A compass needs setting at half the width of the timber. So in this case, that's 35. That's it. Just run that down either side to get close to the centre. And do that on each of the three legs. This cut would be easier with a bandsaw or even a jigsaw, but it's not too difficult to do with a handsaw. You just need to make a couple of cuts to get rid of most of the waste. And then we use a rasp to round it off later. All that's needed is a cheap rasp, and that makes light work of it. Just cleaning up the edges a little. The wedge is butted up against the leg stop, but it needs to be square to the top piece. A bolt is going to go through near the center, just down from the center, for the leg to be bolted onto. So we'll put a screw there, we can put one there, and we'll put one above there. We'll sit the top rail flat like that, and then the leg in position and down, touching the tabletop. In a minute we're going to cut the excess off the wedge, but at the moment that's very handy for us to clamp the leg to it. It's a bit fiddly, but we should be able to manage. That looks nice and flush in there. Using our hole that the compass left, we'll enlarge that a little. We need to drill through, but we need to drill perpendicular to the leg, not to the top. I'm going to hold that up so it's around about level. And as long as it's close, it'll work. And we need to enlarge the hole, and the hole needs to be big enough for that head to sit inside. So for the next leg, we need to work from the opposite side. We won't glue this one for now. It will come back off, and then we'll glue it again later. I think a second clamp to pull that leg up tight isn't a bad idea either. So now we need to go back to the first leg, and we need to put that one aside for the moment. And we need a space at this end. The leg stop, which also acts as a spacer, the opposite end there. So now we can glue and screw the two halves together. We didn't glue this piece on, so we can take it off. The only thing left to do is the single leg, and that lives inside the recess here. And for that to happen, we need to reduce thickness. I'm going to plane it down, but you could sand it or whatever way you can think of, but it just needs a little bit taken off. So that's the leg in position. I'm going to clamp that so it's nice and tight up against the support there. 100. And then we need to come down 40, and I'm just going to eyeball the angle looking down the leg. You can probably see that the leg is positioned just a few millimeters below the top surface. So that's it, it's all done. I just had to take a little bit off the toe so it closed there. Just did that with the plane, and that was it. So there we go.